Un cordial saludo. Bienvenido a la jugada crítica de Telesur.
Today to the Luego de 20 años After 20 years of efforts for its confirmation, the first phase of Mercosur European Union has finally been approved. Several questions are still pending after the steps given by the South American representatives, Brazil and Argentina, and Brussels. They were hailed for their initiative, as opposed to the position of the governments that view the proposal with suspicion. Here we can speak about Emmanuel Macron of France. Is it really a fair agreement, fair for both parties? Who will win and who will lose? What are the risks? If the signed documents has inequities once put in place, in what geopolitical context is the step taken that will define the commercial future of both regions? This is what we're going to be analyzing today. On June 28, Mercosur and the European Union met in Brussels and finished the process of dialogue on the clauses of free trade agreement of goods and services of more than $100 million. The intention is to lower the costs by eliminating import taxes and establishing preferential conditions. To enforce the agreement is required the ratification of the member countries, subject to the approval of their respective congresses. Here, in the statements from the representatives of both blocs regarding the signed agreements, we present the facts. You make your own conclusions. It is a historical moment for Mercosur and for the moment we are living in the world. We have to show commitment to the integration, multilateralism, the opening of markets, free trade, and trade with rules. It is not every day that a significant reduction of barriers is negotiated. We will unlock enormous potential through our industry, services, and agriculture sectors. The number speaks for themselves. It is the greatest agreement ever signed between two European Union and trading partners. There we go. Let's go to the world map and see how an important portion of South America, grouped in Mercosur, which is Brazil, Argentina, Uruguay, Paraguay, plus some of the associate members, would transact across the Atlantic Ocean and governed by a free trade agreement that, according to some, does not respect asymmetries, nor the respect of the peoples. Another fact we must consider is the pact is established with one of the largest blocs of the countries in the world, the European Union, with its 28 or 27 members, depending if the Brexit goes through or not. Let's see a geoeconomical map of this agreement of Mercosur and the European Union. In 2018, the European Commission calculated its exports to Mercosur in $50 billion, while the imports from Argentina, Brazil, Paraguay, and Uruguay, member states with votes and vote in the Mercosur, reached $48 billion. This is $2 billion less than the European bloc. The new treaty involves the integration of the region with a market of 800 million inhabitants, equivalent to almost a quarter of the world gross domestic product, and with more than 100 billion of bilateral trade in goods and services. The pre-agreement signed last Friday in Brussels, but must be ratified by the members' country, seeks to cheapen the cost of imported products and boost the relations between two companies. In addition, it is expected to stimulate employment rates. In terms of tariffs, it could be the most lucrative negotiation of the European Union bloc, with a reduction of $4 billion in taxes. According to experts, one of the sectors that would be benefited from the European Union would be the automobile sector, while the Mercosur will be the agriculture transnationals. In specific case of Brazil, it will result in an export of soy, and in Argentina, of beef. Mercosur will eliminate 35% imposed on European cars and 18% on auto parts. Dairy products, especially cheese, will enter Mercosur free of tariffs.
ingresarán a Mercosur libres de aranceles.
Europe, for its part, changes tariffs to more than 99% of agriculture products of South American countries. This is, import taxes on 81.7% of Mercosur's agriculture goods would be eliminated, while it offers preferences for the remaining 17.7%.
Mientras que ofrece cuotas o preferencias para el 17.7% restante.
There are taxes which will be withdrawn directly and in some cases phased out on an adaptation period of 5 to 10 years. In the pharmaceutical sector, the 14% tariffs on imported products will be eliminated. However, the Mercosur would mean a pressure as a regional products would experience greater competition.
Como le decía, no todo es color.
As I said, not everything is perfect in this agreement. Let's check web pages that illustrate the discontent of some of the parts. Let's begin with Telesur. France will review the European Union-Mercosur agreement before ratifying it. For now, France is not prepared to ratify the convention, signed after 20 years of negotiations. It was declared by the spokeswoman of the French government, Sibeth Indian. It says, guarantees will be sought from the member countries of Mercosur, as was done with the pact signed between the European Union and Canada. Let's go. Brasil de Fato says, agreement with the European Union challenges the alleged positive effects of the pact. This was said by the vice president of BRICS, Paulo Nogueira. He challenged the alleged positive effects of the pact because, according to him, it offers limited addition access to the markets of the European Union and its allies. The expert points out that if the Europeans get all of these advantages, the agreement includes the Americans, the Canadians and Japanese will want the same treatment, which would put an end to Brazil's development policy. He also said, it is an agreement that goes far beyond trade. It is not free. It does not fully establish freedom, but offers little additional access to the markets of the European Union. In one of his responses, he also points out, this agreement is part of the model of the economic agreement that was inaugurated by North American Free Trade Agreement, NAFTA, with Mexico, Canada, and the U.S., a model that delves into the FTAA proposal created by the Americans. As a recommendation, I have a publication called Mercosur, Saving for the European Union, Sacking for South America. It's written by Laura Cruz, and it's on the website Rebellion. It says, South America lives another one of their so-called neoliberal waves and has the extreme right in Brazil, one of the members of Mercosur with which the European Union has signed a trade agreement. It remains to be seen the already evident acceptance of the European Union before the extreme right that represents Jair Bolsonaro. It is not known whether he will call for special measures, although Brazil is a great expanding economic actor. The president has already given carte blanche to issue such as a thinning of Amazon and the posture of 28.
Momento entonces de actualizar información.
Let's go to more information.
Como, por ejemplo, Brasil, la Argentina.
We're seeing about Argentina. We're going to stay with Argentina. Edgardo Esteban, nice to greet you and your audience. As you said, the expectations regarding the agreement with the European Union and Mercosur in regards to the possibility of trade, it gives more of a media effect, at least in Argentina, especially in times of electoral campaign that seems to have a difficult context for the government of Mauricio Macri, who has had difficulties in the economic field, especially in regards to inflation. He may just be seeking to attain the votes of the undecided, However, it still needed to have the approval of the Congress. It's going to take some time. On the other hand, we do not know the small print of this concrete agreement between the European Union and Mercosur. But there's also countries like Ireland and France which are raising questions that are not simple, and in what this construction and this dialogue means, looking towards the regional economies and state themselves. From this perspective, the need for the agreement, which has been negotiated for more than 20 years by sectors of economic interest, has been raised. But there's also sectors such as the Argentinian Industry Union, which means small and medium enterprises, the national industry that's having concrete difficulties. Over 800,000 small and medium enterprises are having difficulties in the Republic of Argentina. They're being closed every day. There are more than 300,000 workers fired. And from that perspective, it's really critical, the possibility of this agreement in the context of Argentina. Many say that there's nothing else than the smoke bomb at election time, but there will be a long road ahead to get the agreement between Mercosur and European Union in effect. Far beyond the euphoria that existed at the time until the chancellor himself praised the agreement and even cried when he told the president that the agreement between the European Union and Mercosur had finally been achieved. The truth is that the effect that just was on internet, but reality is that on everyday context is unchanged. There is still a long way ahead, which is will not be advanced during the electoral period, and probably will go beyond the presidential elections of October and negotiate with the continuing president.
Muchas gracias, Edgardo. Una bomba.
Thank you, Edgardo. He says it's just an air bomb. Let's continue with our next guest. We'll be right back after this pause. Don't go anywhere.
Lo antes posible. No se vaya, ya volvemos.
Why is this the struggle of Brazil and Argentina, both neoliberal governments, to sign this agreement with the European Union? What are the interests at play? This is a question that was hanging before the pause. We're going to develop it now. Both Brazil and Argentina went to the G20 held in Osaka with the objective of signing the free trade agreement with the European Union. Macri was open to the requirements of the European countries, especially France. This was very interesting because when Jair Bolsonaro said that he would stay in the Paris Accord, the agreement between both blocs would also be worried about the environmental situation of the planet. If Bolsonaro maintained his position that the Paris Accord had no sense, then they would not be able to sign this agreement. The governments of Brazil and Argentina showed the agreement as a conquest to celebrate. However, there is not too much that we know about the small writing because there are very scarce the sectors that will be benefited. Apparently, the conditions will be equal between both blocs. However, this does not happen because both the European
negocios del Mercosur.
Companies will have free circulations. However, the Brazilian and Argentinian companies are very few of that will be navigating in European waters. This shows that although both parts have same prerogatives, the conditions of the two blocks are totally different.
Al servicio del viejo continente.
Otro portal que también vale la pena consultar.
Another webpage that we would like to go to is the Página 12 of Argentina, which publishes an article entitled "The Mercosur-European Union Agreement is Fake, Something False That Is Not What It Appears." This is the text from Alfredo Zayat.
Es un texto, dicho sea de paso, de Alfredo Zayat. Él explica.
He explains, the small letter of the Mercosur-European Union is not known. A government that brags of openness to dialogue and consensus advanced in a negotiation dominated by secrecy. How can someone define the productive matrix of a country ignoring the opinion of the industrials and workers of sensitive sectors? This behavior is understood because the President Mauricio Macri believes that the Argentinian industry is outdated and therefore does not deserve to have any priority. Franco has died. Now it's turn for him to put the industry away.
En primer lugar se encuentra la automotriz, donde el grupo Macri, dicho sea de paso, fue uno de sus protagonistas. Se debe sumar una.
We must add a very short-term reason. This is to apply a political marketing strategy with the aim of having something to show in these election months in front of the that he has accumulated a succession of spectacular fiascos in these 3.5 years of the Macri economy.
De la economía macrista. Fíjense cuánto paralelismo hay entre esa opinión del diario Página 12 y lo que
Página 12
explicaba nuestro corresponsal.
And what our corresponsal said.
Justo a Buenos
to
Aires
us.
Me voy también.
Oh, now we're going to Buenos Aires. We're going to speak talking to Pablo Viles.
De la Casa Patria Grande.
He is a specialist in the topic. We welcome you to our space, as well as
Carlos Martinez.
He's a lawyer, and he's joining us from Spain. Welcome to Critical Moves. Let's start with Pablo. Apparently, this agreement is a success, but is it a success for who? Hi, Ray. Thank you for inviting me. Greetings to everybody. In fact, this is just an air bomb. This is just an electoral move on behalf of President Macri and his allies to try to gain an election that's already lost according to the polls. This was negotiated after 20 years because it coincides with Argentina and Brazil that are totally willing to give up everything to Europe. Because before, with President with Lula and Cristina and Néstor, where all of the sovereignty and the work was defended. However, now these governments are totally different. They're not worried about the people. As well as Edgardo Esteban said, Bolsonaro in Argentina, they don't care to destroying the internal work and not produce medications, and they don't care if people are going to die due to the low of consumption of people. And this announcement of the agreement with the European Union is a product of all of their policies they've been applying and the destruction of employment. It's not by luck that all of the terms are maintained secret. Nobody knows the terms, the unions, the NGOs, these people who are going to be the most benefit or on the contrary, but they don't know. The asymmetry between these two blocks is very evident, and the negotiations began to be at fault because Mercosur has left behind one of the members, which is the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela. We're going to be speaking about this further down the road. Let's talk with Carlos Martinez from Spain. We were talking with Pablo about the advantages and disadvantages that would bring this agreement. And who is, I would like to know, who is hiding behind these agreements? To the mind comes of these transnational companies that might be expecting to have better benefits. Well, good afternoon. Well, this agreement that is so-called a free trade will lead that the big companies and the large automobile industries, chemistries, and on the other hand, we could think that maybe the agriculture and the farming people of Mercosur could be benefited, but this is not so, because we know that
tiene la parte grande de ganancia no son los agricultores, los ganaderos, sino son las transnacionales.
Because we know that it's not who are going to earn the money is not the farmers, but the big transnational companies.
Para favorecer a los trabajadores.
This is not being done to favor the workers and the farmers. On the contrary, it's going to benefit the big companies that will have a bigger market to sell to. Of course, it's called free trade, but it's fake. This is not true, because it's not that there's not going to be any type of barriers. It's just going to favor the big sectors. And of course, they speculate with prices. And at the end of the day, the working class will not receive anything.
Pablo,
stay with us, please. Carlos, Pablo, something that's been criticized to the Macri government is that the small and medium companies have not been taken into account before the signing of this agreement. According to several news media, they say that we would like to know if there's a will to help the small businesses, because this is not clear for us. Well, no, he's not even thinking of the small and medium-sized companies in this agreement. He hasn't done it ever since he took office. Just look at the public policy he's been promoting from 2015. They have all been against the small and medium-sized companies. He's taken away all subsidies to help the internal commerce, which would have been the base of any type of equality within an agreement. If a president doesn't do it on a national level, he will never do it on an international level. This agreement just seeks to benefit the big companies. So the free trade is only going to be useful for the companies who do have this big trade. And on the contrary, they're going to be exploiting our natural resources, and we're going to lose at the end. So it's not only that he didn't bear in mind the small and medium companies, it's even worse, because he's lying to them. He's not telling them all the truth, because he's just going to be importing things with less tariffs, but it's only going to be benefited the auto parts, the auto companies. However, our agriculture will not be benefited. And we're going to be confronted with countries like France that have a great protectionism system.
Ya empezó a avisar un interés de firmar un tratado de libre comercio también con Estados Unidos, lo cual implotaría directamente cualquier capacidad.
And we can see that he probably wants to sign an agreement with the U.S., which would totally devastate the companies in Argentina. Let's go back to Carlos. Much has been said about this alleged failure of Macri's government,
del cual aún no se sabe nada a ciencia cierta, y algo que no me
es importante,
la crisis de migrantes en el Mediterráneo.
That is not less important is the international economy. When Mercosur is going to work with the European Union, what are they going to be held to? Well, it's true that both blocs have great differences. Well, the European bloc has been using this bloc for many years, and they're constantly growing. This model has been in crisis just during the last years. It's a lesson that Mercosur must learn. But what is evident is that Europe now is still unequal. And what we see is that the richest countries are richer, and the poorer countries are even more poor. And especially, we can see Greece. Greece is a country that is not able to improve. If you just believe of a single model market, and we take into account the common interests, Mercosur is a less advanced process. And the countries that are part of Mercosur, there are countries that are totally different. Uruguay, for example, has the largest potential than Paraguay. So if we have a single market with different capacities of the sellers, this is a lesson that Mercosur should learn. Mercosur must take into account that what happens with the European Union is also subject to their stability. It's not the same to negotiate with United Kingdom within the European Union or when they're outside. You speak about a certain stability of the European Union, but don't you think it's suspicious that France says that they're not going to just sign this agreement with Mercosur? Emmanuel Macron takes a protectionist position. Well, France has always been protectionist. First of all, the agriculture and farming sectors in France are a very strong sector. France is globalizing to obtain the resources from Africa or South America. And for example, they're always able to get cheaper gas. However, if we want the agriculture services to go into Europe, Brazil is already saying that if they're not able to comply to the environmental laws, they will not be exporting anything.
Por motivos reales o no, pero que tendrá que ver con los productos sanitarios que sean que muchos.
So there are many protocols that will have to be observed.
Con las políticas del gobierno ultraderechista de Brasil respecto al medio ambiente.
And let's not forget that this ultra-right government of Brazil also has their own restrictions. And we have to think that we have to expect that this competition not goes against the environment. Pablo, do you think that the South is ready to go head-to-head with the European Union? Just to mention an example, in the pharmaceutical company, there's going to be a benefit to the buyers with all of the access of medicines that come from Europe. But of course, this is going to be competition for the South American producers. Unfortunately, what we're facing, especially Brazil and Argentina, are governments that are highly cynical. What does this have to do? That the respect to the institutions is being destroyed, so there is no capacity to defend the consumers. There's nobody to defend them.
En beneficio primero entre estas nuevas transacciones que proponen. Tampoco es real que este acuerdo.
And it's not true either that this agreement is signed. What they've said, that it's just been a media thing for a negotiation that are still pending. And what we're going to see
la supresión de uno de los poderes de los Estados-naciones de Argentina.
Is the suppression. I mean, these agreements have to be approved by the parliaments of both countries. And however, Macri and Bolsonaro have already announced it. And they said that they're going to execute the parts of this agreement without the previous approval of the parliament. I don't think that the immediate future for our region will be prosperous should this agreement be approved with the characteristics that are written down. But we still don't know because most of the things that we're saying are based with the leaks that we receive from somebody that passes the information. But we have no certainty because we haven't seen the agreement. If we understand that it's an electoral tool, then in 1 week, there'll be a summit of Mercosur next week, and Bolsonaro and Macri want to have it as a triumph of their own government. It's not positive that the agreement with these conditions be carried out. That's why in Argentina there will be a big mobilization protest of the small and medium companies to generate a dialogue and have a position and present our needs.
What is
important is to alert the small and medium companies with sirens to tell them that there's not going to be any opportunity of equal competition between two different blocks like the European Union and the Mercosur. Because of what we've also seen is how deliberately they didn't include one of the members and they blocked the entrance of Bolivia, which would be a very interesting element to be able to sit down in equal conditions with this European Union. And the European Union has proven how there are governments that they don't care to leave immigrants dying on their coasts.
Por ser samaritanos, buenos samaritanos, y acá en Argentina, gobiernos que dejan morir a ciudadanos mayores bajo.
They let people die, same like here in Argentina. That it's the same situation. Well, they're governments that have been led by businessmen. To both of our guests, I thank you a lot. Let's go to our second pause. And when we're back, we will speak with another guest. Thank you very much. We're going to be analyzing what the role of Venezuela is going to be.
is
in this, in this agreement between the Mercosur and the European Union. Bolivia, on the other hand, has not entered to the Mercosur. We'll be right back. Thank you very much.
El acuerdo entre
the agreement between Mercosur and the European bloc is not approved in isolation. Take into account the geopolitical that today is marked by the tariff war between China and the United States, a Russia that presents itself as a thriving power and mediator of the regional conflicts, the recently concluded G20 and the OPEC meeting at which the agreement of adjustments in oil production was ratified in order to maintain the crude prices in the international market. The free market, the free trade agreement signed between the European Union and Mercosur favors both if we look at the global trade geopolitics with both blocs. With different trajectories, do not have the same leading role on the scale since the great battle of between China and the U.S. To a lesser extent, the power of oil with the Arab countries appears. At the technological and the industrial level, countries of Southeast Asia are captained, all of them within the tone of that battle between Beijing and Washington. Within this framework, the European Union is displaced with potential representing of 20% of the world GDP. In this context, adding Mercosur to an agreement that benefits it brings and gives the continent bloc some momentum. For Mercosur, it means following the illusion of finding supposed benefits in linking with free trade, where the conditions of most powerful are clearly imposed. That illusion is where neoliberalism historically preaches and that today dominates Brazil, Argentina, Paraguay, and central countries of Mercosur. With the coming of neoliberal governments, the new governments have signed abruptly. In Argentina, Mauricio Macri needs to recover the initiative of with this upcoming election. This is a type of an integration where the southern countries are still left to being giving raw materials.
Lo prometido es deuda. Al análisis
we said we're going to be talking with Simón Colmenares.
Del sistema económico comunal, Simón.
He's a specialist in this area.
Gracias por
Thank you for coming to Telesur.
Ahora, Simón,
how good has it been for the governments of Mercosur of leaving Venezuela out of this agreement? Do you think that they were seeing this upcoming agreement? And maybe they would have been a problem for us? Well, this treaty has been discussed for 20 years. And now the thing is that these countries that are negotiating are neoliberal.
Neoliberal del Mercosur, donde evidentemente no caben las ideas.
And of course, in the neoliberal spectrum, the ideas of Venezuela have no space. Of course, what Chavez said, with our laws, we could not be participating because only there it's not an equal treaty. What's behind all of this? There's a lot to do with of the work, of employment, and having access to strategic markets. But let's think that we can produce rare soils, and for example, the
Sin embargo, la Unión Europea lo incluyó en la lista.
There are some products that are not interesting for them. And in this agreement, Mercosur and the European Union, they have access to everything. No limitations. Because for each government, these materials are strategic. Well, in this case, it doesn't. There's no protection.
De África, pero en mayor medida de China, que es la potencia mundial. Entonces, por supuesto, lo que tú
so, of course, what you said is something that we could see. We could foresee because Venezuela has a huge reservoir of these precious natural resources. So this is totally planned.
Tampoco estaría obligada.
So, well, if Venezuela has no participation, we don't have to give up any of our resources. Well, I'm not sure. Because, well, Venezuela is suspended. And that means that we're still members. But we're suspended. So we can't speak, we don't have a vote, but we're still subject to the rules that have been approved.
Lo van nuevamente a reincorporar de pleno.
I don't know if we're going to be brought again into this agreement, but of course it would be in it would not be to our best interest.
Y lo que es para el público la parte mediática, 4,000 millones en reducción, pero esos 4,000 millones para el empresario, quiere decir que los productos van a ser más económicos.
4 billion in reduction. You would think that this is going to be good for the people. But it's not. Why? Because it's going to be very, very cheap employees.
So Europe will send
Mercosur.
It's
going to sell to Mercosur things to be finished. And of course, our working force is much cheaper.
Exactamente. Y cuatro que prácticamente estarían sujetos a la tercerización.
A la tercerización y de modo barato. Con esta metodología,
the level of salaries in Europe is 4 times larger than in South America.
Es un modo también legitima la maquila. Por eso decía legitima el neoliberalismo salvaje.
So this is just another neoliberal measure.
Y las micropymes, o sea, las industrias y las pequeñas y medianas empresas no se van a
afectar. And the small and medium industries are going to be totally affected.
Por otro lado está el tema.
On the other hand, we have the case of Bolivia. So do you think this is why Bolivia has been taking so long to come in with all of the rights to Mercosur? Let's ask it another way. Once the agreement is signed, if it's signed,
podría entrar de pleno Bolivia, pero
could Bolivia come in 100% subject to these rules? Of course, Bolivia as a non-member,
a no ingresar.
Exactamente.
Porque también hay reservorios. Claro, por supuesto.
It could decide not to enter this Mercosur.
La parte ideológica, humanista de Venezuela allí haciendo los plenos derechos, pues en esas opiniones que eso es necesario, porque esto es una catástrofe.
This is a catastrophe.
Yo creo que posiblemente se va a aprobar.
I think that it's probably going to be approved.
El por qué la presión de
but
Francia.
But why is the pressure of France?
Simplemente es una presión porque ellos dentro de los estatutos que firmaron exigen respeto a todas esas condiciones.
They ask respect to all of these conditions.
Argentina y Brasil se sometan.
So they will have to be submissive, future rights through this agreement. Europe would have access to strategic material, and they would have access to very cheap handwork.
Son contados con las manos. Sus productos simplemente van a tener pleno derecho a ingresar a nuestras zonas. Los productos aquí difícilmente van a competir contra ellos.
And of course, if you can see that we're going to have to receive their products, but we won't be able to compete with our products to take into Europe. So it's going to be unfair.
Que se deriva de la parte vacuna de Argentina.
For example, leather.
A nivel de desarrollo local, que es lo que tiene que ver con el desarrollo endógeno, no va a existir desarrollo local.
There's not going to be any local development.
De estos estados, y mucho menos una sustitución selectiva de esas importaciones.
And there's not going to be any substitution of our importations. And the people will keep the same salaries. And, well, in Argentina, they may even go even lower.
¿A quién beneficia Pedro Sánchez en España, que fue el quinto?
Well, Pedro Sánchez is going to be benefit because we have to see who's going to be benefit also, Macri, because he's in the middle of the elections and he can show this as a, something he did.
Ya para finalizar y establecer
okay, to finish our interview.
¿Pudiéramos interpretar entonces
Do you think that we could interpret
lo que hasta ahora
that up until now we know of the agreement
un futuro sometimiento de
as a future submission of South America to the orders of the European Union, very much like the Middle Ages when we were just a colony and we just had to give them, supply them with raw resources? Well, yeah, it's a parallel method that Trump is using, because we're being submitted by force, by somebody who's yelling at us. It's going to be like a neo-colony. And the fact, I think that it's most likely to be approved. Thank you very much, Simón, for being with us. You're always welcome to our set. Let's establish conclusions.
Acompañamos a los pueblos que resisten en cada una de sus luchas.
Somos esa ventana que se abre para visibilizarlos entre fronteras.
Inverted pattern, when analyzed what comes to South America from Europe, 90% of what the European Union sells to Mercosur is made up of manufacturers. This highlights the inequality of the agreement signed at Brussels. The so-called Old Continent thus tries to shield itself from the commercial point of view, while South America would return to its role of colony in charge of supplying the metropoli.
Volveremos entonces.
We'll see each other on another play. Thank you very much for being with us.